Hey guys, here I am beginning my second bushcrafting adventure. Found a nice little place for a day camp. Check this out. There's a big tree, there's my pack. Big arcing branch. It goes all the way down to the stream. Here's a nice little partly flat area. Over here, we have vegetation. I don't know, 15 to 20 feet up. There's the stream. I'd still like to cross it, but yeah, we'll see, maybe later. That's the way I came in. So let me get my camp set up. And I'll be right back. Hey guys, I'm gonna go through my gear I brought with me today real quickly. Here I have warm gloves, ski gloves, leather gloves. Thanks, Jeff. I found these nice leather gloves. This is a piece of heavy aluminum. It was an aluminum container, to-go container. I just folded the edges down flat. That's for going under the stove. This is my kneeling pad, cut to fit the shape of the inside of my pack. Canteen and stove. This is my alcohol stove kit. Matches, alcohol stove, alcohol. Little syringe for retrieving the unburned alcohol. Let's see how that goes, see if it's worth it. Lunch is a can of soup, and I'm just going to cook it in the can. I've been thinking a lot about cooking on the trail, and this seems like the easiest thing to do is just cook it in the can, and then you can put all your trash in the can and carry it out with you and just throw it away. No fuss, no muss. Here's a little slingshot. Got on eBay. Steel saw from Chris. Black Forest Ghost one. Thank you, Chris. I've used this a few times. I'm going to be using it again today. Thank you. That is excellent quality. It's a pleasure to use that saw. All right. Here is a bag of bushcraft stuff. My friends. My friend Sammy sent me Japanese candy. I haven't tried yet. She says it's not very good. Notepad, actually, that's mine. I'm going to write down things I wish I had brought with me. There's a pen Sammy sent me. A little cotton ball soaked in beeswax fire starter. Big fire starter. Not going to use this today. I'm going to use an alcohol stove because everything is wet. Wet, wet, wet. And I don't want a really smoky fire. And flashlight. Super bright. I think it's 14 LEDs. Super bright, in case I need to look down a rabbit hole or something, see if anybody's home. So, gonna try out all those things today, Sammy. Over here I have camera case, little tripod, selfie stick. Over there I have my bigger tripod, coffee mug with coffee, creamer, sugar, bank line, and a garbage bag. I'm already wishing I had two garbage bags with me, because I could make waders. Thanks for the idea, Sammy. Make waders to cross that stream. So, I will definitely be adding another garbage bag to my kit. And here, just have a few things. Bandana, first aid kit, sewing kit, duct tape on the back. Oh, my monocular, also from Chris, Black Forest Ghost. Thank you, Chris. I'm going to put this on right now. I'm not in a position where I can see any distance right now, but I will be. So, I'll put that on. So far, I've only used it for spying on my neighbors. Sharpie, mirror. This was a compact makeup mirror I got at the dollar store. It's good because it's in a plastic case. Protects it. Paracord I got from Doc Pitt. Pitt Anula. Spork. A couple of Ziploc bags. And this is just nails. Oh, and a Walmart grocery bag. I might use that for trash. I'm definitely packing my trash out. Definitely. Okay. Stand by. I'm going to put you on the... I'm going to get my stove set up and then I'll put you on the tripod. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Show you what we got going on here. We got... six very wet sticks for base. Aluminum. There's a stove and a little primer spill protector. Right. Canteen stove with bars going both ways to make it to make this can of soup very stable, and a windscreen made out of a cookie sheet from the dollar store. So, and all this ground is very wet, so I have no fear of starting a forest fire. Here's fuel. This little stove, actually it's just a 2-ounce cat food can. If you put 2 ounces of fuel in here, it will burn for 33 minutes. 33 minutes! And it's not a super hot heat because it's not jetted. So it's perfect for cooking something like this. So, I don't think I need 33 minutes of cook time, but I can always retrieve any leftover alcohol, put it back in the bottle. So, there you go. Can't see it, but it is burning. It is hot. Off so I can stir it. Didn't even need my P38. lunch is cooking. Spork. This is a Light My Fire spork. You get two of them at Walmart for $4. I didn't really want two. I just wanted one, but I have a spare. Yeah, this is going to be good. It's going to take quite a while to eat. Oh, I should have took the label off. I should definitely take the label off. Back we go. And I am not a litter bug. I am packing out all my trash and probably other people's trash as well. And as soon as the soup is done, I will start coffee. Water for coffee. Make sure it's still going. Sit here like an idiot while my flame is out. So that's ready to go. Alright, while that's cooking, I'm going to look for a stick to make a tent stake. My goal is to have six of them. I made two last time. So let's see what's out there. Thank you for the saw, Chris. I made cutting these sticks so quick and easy. I had to change the battery in the camera. Found a good stick. Thanks again for the saw, Chris. It's a godsend. The soup is heating up. Got some bubbles. I should have timed it. It's been about 10 minutes. And it's warm. But not ready. Okay. Let's see what we can do with this. These are all Russian olive trees. I don't know if they actually have olives, but they do have thorns. Still is doing well. Soup's kind of bubbling. little after 12 noon. I'm ready for my lunch. Last time I was doing this with the K-bar. This knife is more comfortable, and I really didn't need the 7-inch blade. This is the Condor Bush Lore, made in El Salvador. I love it. I am not looking for another bushcraft knife. I love it. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that's hot. So, let's take him off the stove. Here. And eat some water for coffee. That was, I don't know, 15 minutes maybe. With no lid on the pot. I probably will make a lid. I just haven't done it yet. I'm going to use a saw to make this end and cut it at an angle. Use a saw to make it straight. Much better. Back to that later. It's lunchtime. I'll be back. Hey guys, I'm back. Finished my soup. That was good. That was really good. And I made my coffee. Still too hot to drink. So, packing up my trash. That's all I have so far. Do have a little bit of alcohol left in here, so I'm gonna recover that and put it back in the bottle. With a handy little syringe. Quite a bit. 3 cc's. And there's a little bit more. About half a cc. 3.5 cc's. Recovered. That's pretty cool. Alright, that's worth saving. Kit. that air dry. Well, that was kind of a pain. This little Sony camera, I bought a second battery for it, but now it's run out of memory. So I had to switch to my phone. I don't know if it's worth buying a second memory card for it. Eh, they're cheap enough. Anyway, so where were we? Oh, yes. I'm gonna let the stove air dry. One of my supports got all crispy on the end. I don't know why. Dress it up a little with a file. Right now. He's starting to put things away. Finish my coffee. We'll do some more exploring. I haven't seen any good rocks for my slingshot. I was thinking about using that deer droppings or whatever it was. Anyway, let's go back to the tent stake. Chamfer the end, they say, that prevents it from splitting when you're hammering it or pounding it with a rock. I guess it's true. I do love this knife. Condor Bush Lore. $36 on Amazon, I think. You could pay a lot more, or you can get a Mora for a lot less. But I'm happy with it. Not bad. Now I gotta put a point on it. I drew a circle where I want the point to be. So I got a ways to go. and it doesn't need to be 1 inch diameter. That's a zombie killing tent stake for sure. That's basically the point I want. Can you see that? Alright, now I need to put a notch here. On my other two stakes, I made a circle all the way around for the rope. On this one, I'm just going to make a regular notch. There. It's a very hard wood. Look at that. Looks like a mouth. Getting closer. Looks pretty good. Is it deep enough? I think it's good. Yeah. Strip off the rest of the bark. And we will have another fine tent stake. that's good enough for today. Alright guys, I'm gonna finish my coffee and do a little more exploring. I will turn the camera back on if I find anything cool, or if I find a way across the stream. Otherwise, yeah, thanks for joining me. It's been fun. Peace out. There's a big pile of branches. I don't know why. Look at this. This is for you, Doc Ink. Look at that big tree. It's not that tall, but it's been here a long time. There's two more. Not that tall. I think these are sycamore trees. To give you an idea, I will flip the camera around. Stand by. Look at that. That is a big tree. Right on. All right, let's keep moving. Look at that duck. It's really moving. Yep, that is the Yakima River. All right. Let's keep going. What do you think of this, Doc? Looks like a haunted forest, right? Doc Ink?